Hello guys, and welcome back to another video. This is Africa Football Connect and I'm your host Sam. So we are talking Ole Gunnar Solskjaer and Jadon Sancho again. The story just refused to go away. So there have been a lot of things that has been happening in this situation, and different transfer news that has happened before then and that. But the Manchester United versus Ole Gunnar Solskjaer situation is just refusing to go away, so I'm gonna cover it a little bit later, so you need to stick out for that so that you might enjoy it in the end. But if you are watching this for the first time and you like the content that I'm sharing, please consider subscribing. And to those who watches, who just watches but they're not subscribing, please click that subscribe button and like the video, because it helps the video, the channel, a lot. So let's get started. So I'm going to cover other transfer news, then go straight to Ole Gunnar Solskjaer in the end when I'm finishing this thing. So like I told you yesterday, we confirmed that Barcelona had signed Ronald Koeman. Now they were just unveiling the new coach of Barcelona, the new manager of Barcelona, and we'll wait and see whatever that's going to happen. But he was announced yesterday, so they're saying this: photo confirmation of Ronald Koeman's appointment as Barcelona's new head coach or manager, if we can say that. That's what we've learned to know, right? So that's what has happened, Barcelona fans. You can be happy now because now you have a better manager. I believe in my say, I feel like he's a better manager than the one who was taken out. So we'll wait and see. Then another done deal again. Sheffield United have completed the signing of Aaron Ramsdale from AF Bournemouth for an 18.5 million euro. Pounds, in fact, not euro. So this has happened also, and the source of the information is Sheffield. So congratulations to both the player and the club. I hope you can replace and you can fill Dean Henderson's shoes that he has left at Sheffield United. So tell me what you think on this situation and what do you expect. Everyone are just saying good luck Henderson, because most of the Sheffield United were still what, so attached with the Anderson, but the Anderson decided that he wants to go fight for his jersey at Manchester United, so he has to go. So you have to accept that is going to be happening, which is the new keeper that is coming in. And also, Dan Deal, scouting Carlson has extended his loan deal with Manchester City for another year. So it means that there's another coach. Oh yeah, his name is scouting from the Manchester City Board of Coaches, and he has extended his deal again to continue again with the club for another year. It's actually a loan, not a deal, like, so it's, we'll see what will happen. Let me hear what you're saying in the comments. There's this guy by the name of Abuja something, I don't know how to say. He's saying that Edison has been bad lately, please teach him well. Also, he's a goalkeeper coach, so he's telling this guy that please, can you teach the main goalkeeper of Manchester City well, because Edison has been really terrible. And the Manchester City fans, you can actually agree with me, he has been really terrible, and we cannot hide that. And as we continue with the news, and on the another news, it's coming from London, and they are saying that Arsenal are on the verge of agreeing personal terms with Lille defender Gabriel Magalhães. So yesterday we heard that Napoli had made a late deal, had made a late bid for the player, but it seems like the player was in the interest of Arsenal, Everton and Napoli. But it seems like Arsenal are the ones who are leading the race, because they're already on the verge of agreeing out personal deals with the player, because it was believed that the club had actually accepted all the deals from both sides, in Napoli side and the Arsenal side. So it was between the player to make his decision which club he's preferring. So it seems like he's preferring to go to Arsenal. So good luck to you guys. Let's hear very soon when it will be announced, because you never know what happens. So let me hear what you're saying in the comments. Takiso is saying this: that guy can't even jump, poor Arsenal. Oh my god, I don't know how the player plays, but we'll have to wait and see. Maybe I'm gonna check on YouTube, there are some videos I think that have already been made about him as a defender. If he's going to Arsenal, that's what we always do in the English Premier League. You always get data of every player who moves there. Then, Bougie Judy said that. Is that like his name? Bougie Judy? Okay, Judy? Yeah. Judy said that personal terms are over. The player will sign a 5-year deal with Arsenal Medicals tomorrow. Oh, wow. That's powerful. Do you have a source to back your story, Judy? Because what I just said here, they gave me a source over there. They're saying that it's actually a source from the club. So, because you can say a situation that will be confused. Can you do me this favor? Give me a link where I can go confirm your story. If you're saying that five deal has already been agreed and made, because tomorrow meaning today, can you give me a source? Oh, let me read, because the same story exactly 1 hour ago. Lily defender Gabriel Martinez, he will sign for Arsenal in the upcoming hours after shaking off interest from Napoli. The 22-year-old centre-back will join a 5-year deal on the Gunners tomorrow, and the source is Daily Mirror. So, Judy, you're telling the truth. It seems like the personal contract between the club and the person are already on the verge of finishing. So medicals, maybe they're being done today, and the person will sign exactly for how much did they say? They said they will sign for about 5 years or 5 year deal. We don't know how much you'll be getting, so we'll have to wait and see. Let me hear what you say on the situation. My question is, this is Safari saying this. My question is, if Lily completed the signing of Nicolas Pepe, he's talking about the deal between Nicolas Pepe and Arsenal. Lastly, what I heard, it seems like it was not yet really done, but we have to wait and see what happens. And the Oli and Man United will be fighting for 10 finishes with Southampton and Aston Villa. What are they talking about? We'll be fighting for finishing 10. Oh, Brian Chess is saying that Southampton and Aston Villa with Manchester United, they'll be fighting for position 10 next season. That's a broad statement to actually bring out. We have to wait and see what happens. So it seems like a deal's being done. So that's why we're hearing. So Chelsea Football Club are considering centre-back Thiago Silva on a free transfer to blossom Frank Lampard, to boost Frank Lampard's defense for next season. So it seems like Thiago Silva, after they finish with PSG in the Champions League, it means that his current deal will be running off. So it seems like Chelsea wants to get the Brazilian, and so that they can try to boost their defense, because it has been really, really terrible. So we have to wait and see on that one. So like I was saying, the final news that I wanted to give you guys is that Ole Gunnar Solskjaer wanted Jadon Sancho to be announced as Manchester United player upon confirmation of Champions League qualification. Still nearly 4 weeks have passed, and there still remain a gap in the player's valuation, salary, and even the agent's fee. So Manchester United wanted to sign this player. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer wanted this player. But as we speak, they have not yet reached the agreement with Dortmund. They have not yet reached an agreement with what they want with the salary of the player, because the player wants more that Manchester United are not willing to offer. And also the agent's fee. So it seems like for a deal like this to be happening, it doesn't seem like it's going to happen this year or even this season. I don't think that anything will come out or will even materialize from this deal. So every day we keep being reminded of this thing, and it's getting to us now, because we were told by Dortmund, they made it so clear that this deal was over and there was nothing that was going to happen. But the Manchester United are not willing to take that as the final word. They are still trying by all means, trying to bring up all these old stories so that they try to get something done. But if you can't get anything done, if you're not even agreeing with the player that you want, remember he gave you the amount he wants to be given every week, but you're not agreeing with that. The agent's fee, it's not yet being agreed. And also, you haven't agreed with even Dortmund. So what's going to happen exactly, Manchester United? Tell me what you think on this deal, Manchester United fans. Is this thing going to come to an end, or we are going to keep being told that something might happen, because it keeps happening each and every day? And I have to tell you something, it's now starting getting on our nerves, and some of us who are not even interested in the situation. So tell me what you think, guys. That's the information we have for you today. And before we go, we want to remind you that in 1 hour time now, or maybe now, the Premier League will be announcing They'll be announcing the pre oh, in fact, I think it's happening now. So Sky Sports are saying right now, who will be facing your club? Who is your club facing first? Follow all the reaction as the Premier League fixtures will be announcing the release of the Premier League in the next minute, I think. I don't know what time exactly. I don't know what time. We have to find out. We have to find out what time exactly it is. But they'll be announcing the Premier League fixtures, and I will be talking about the big games that will be set and on which day they'll be happening. If you check the other video that I did, the former, they were actually showing us what will be happening, but they'll be announcing very soon. So we'll be keeping everything on that, and we'll keep tags on that and see what happens. But that's the information we have at the moment, guys. And please don't forget to go on Facebook and search Africa Football Connect. After searching Africa Football Connect, it will appear a page. It's a group where you can actually try to join in so that you never miss anything that will be happening in Africa Football Connect. And also, you can actually connect with us in the Africa Football Connect by leaving your comments and your questions. I'll be answering them as I can, or maybe we'll be actually putting it on the platform so that we can actually talk about it. That will be happening when we are going live, because we are working so hard to try to fix some of the things where we have, so that we can actually go live and speak to you on a live basis. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope that you click this and you actually enjoy for this. Please don't forget to click subscribe. Don't forget to click subscribe and click the bell icon, because it helps the page a lot, and we can actually connect and enjoy whatever we'll be doing more. So thank you very much for watching. This has been Sam, and I'm signing off, and we'll meet again in a few moments after Premier League announce their Premier League fixtures of next season. So thank you. Bye.